Hi everyone out there. Spotboy has a very, very special guest today. It's Zoa Morani, COVID-19 free, if I can say that. And it's such a moment of happiness for all of us, you know, that not only she, but her sister Shahza and her father, Kareem Morani, has also, all three of them have now tested negative, and all three back home. And I can imagine the happiness, especially with her mom. And Zoa, let's start right from there, you know, the whole thing, how it all began at your place. I mean, you returned from Rajasthan, as much as I know, and your sister was away in Sri Lanka for a short holiday. And then what happened?
So my sister, she was away in Sri Lanka first week of March. Then she came back after a couple of days, but she didn't start showing symptoms till about 18th March. So I think a day after I got back from Rajasthan, she got a fever, followed by me getting a fever the next day. And fever and this weird kind of a tiredness. It felt like as if I haven't slept in 3 nights, or, you know, like a very strange feeling I was going through. But we didn't want to look into it too much, because we thought maybe we were getting paranoid because we're reading so much of the news and so much about the symptoms. So, you know, maybe we're just getting influenced by that. Let's just wait and see. But then after 3-4 days, I started getting this cough, and it was like as if it was a really bad cold, like my head started hurting, and I had shortness of breath, and it felt like as if something is stuck in my chest and coming in between my breathing. Like it was becoming difficult to breathe, kind of a thing. So then I think when we realized that, okay, you know, everything seems to be matching exactly like everything that we're reading about the symptoms, so maybe we should talk to the doctor. And then after speaking to our doctor, it was his decision when he told us that maybe we should get tested.
And Dr. R.K. Agarwal, your family physician.
Ji, that's right.
And then, I mean, you all both went for the test same, but I think the first day you got it negative.
So they came home to take the test from this lab, and for some reason my sister tested positive and I tested negative, and my sister's symptoms had stopped. She had a really bad headache for 7 days, and, you know, this weird pain in her ears and a fever. But she was having a lot of hot drinks, and she was doing steam, and she took some antibiotics, and the headache went. After 7 days, she was showing no symptoms. On the other hand, I was showing symptoms. My fever had continued, the shortness of breath, the chest congestion, all that was still continuing. But we decided to do the test, because when my sister and me started showing the symptoms, we isolated from our parents. We were not meeting our parents anymore, and, you know, we were just being careful just in case. So once Shahza's symptoms stopped, we thought just before she should go start mingling with my parents again, maybe we should just test for safety. So then we tested, and I don't know how my test was negative and Shahza's was positive, but my symptoms were really bad that day. So our doctor said that maybe I should go to the emergency room. When they sent my sister to the hospital, they sent me to an emergency room just to check my vitals, because the fever was really high. So then when they checked my vitals, they realized that the pulse and everything is a bit of a concern. So maybe they should just admit me into the hospital and take one more test just for safety, since my sister tested positive. And then that second test in the hospital was positive for me.
Okay. So, sorry to ask you this, but what was the first reaction when you realized that you are positive? And you knew so much about this new disease and, you know, the state of the affairs in the country, all over the world. And what did you feel? I mean, what was the first feeling?
You know, actually, it was the build-up towards that one episode was so much, because we had already gone through 10 days of symptoms at home. And, you know, the paranoia and the fear and the constant doubt, is it really COVID? Is it not COVID? So all of that was so exhausting that finally when I was in the hospital and finally when the test came and they were like, okay, it's positive, I was like, okay, theek hai, at least now I know, okay, this is it. And, you know, at least we can move ahead. At least they'll treat me for it, because I was getting a little fed up of the symptoms and trying to self-medicate and deal with it on my own. So, yes, I was relieved in that sense. But, of course, it was really, really scary. I was alone. I was by myself. It was just my doctor and me. But my doctor was really, really sweet. He was, I don't know, there was something about him. He was just so kind and so sensitive, and the way he came and he gave me the news so casually, and there was just something about him that he gave me so much strength that I was just like, oh, really? Oh, I'm positive. Oh, okay. It was like I already knew. Obviously, I knew, you know, but when you hear it, it's still like a blow. But yeah, I was thankful to my doctor, and then I called my parents and my sister on video call, and it was weird. It was like I knew also, but then hearing it, it's a little weird also. And
so
it was strange.
The parents must be traumatized because Shaza was already admitted to Kokila, and now you were going to start treatment in Nanavati. So it must be a double
opposite. Shaza was in, yeah. No, but actually my mom and my dad, they were getting worried because they were wanted to know what is happening to me, right? Because the fever hadn't gone, and we needed to figure out, is it some other viral? And usually I never fall sick. Like in the last 5, 6, 7 years, I don't remember falling sick ever. And here, suddenly since 12 days, I'm running a fever and like this weird cough and all these things. So I think they were also somewhere at least relieved that it's been diagnosed, and so at least now they can start treating me.
But काफी जल्दी आप लोग घर आ गए. मतलब मेरे ख्याल से काफी दिनों से पहले से होगा कि वो that period had all gone by. You know that maybe a large part of the 14 days or the 15 days which you take one text. So
possible, it was, very possible.
It seems like, and that's my, again, I'm not a doctor, but you know, it's even your dad back home. In a shorter time than otherwise, other more patients are like taking. So I think he also must be having, since a little while.
So Papa actually had zero symptoms. It was so strange when he tested positive because we were so careful at home when he had started showing the symptoms earlier on. And he didn't even have any symptoms. In fact, we were making sure that we kept asking them to check their fever every day to see that they're not like, you know, that they're very far away from each other and all these things. But he was zero symptom. I mean, he was completely asymptomatic, and even in the hospital, no symptoms. But he was still in the hospital for 9 days till his final negative test came. So I actually don't know how that happened.
Now, how are you guys quarantining yourself? I mean, the three of you and mom also, I mean, at home, what is the system of, you know, washing the utensils, washing the, I mean, clothes?
Yeah, so we all have rooms, our own utensils, kitchen. Own clothes. Everything is, we don't let anything out of the room. Also, my father and my mother can't stay together for 14 days. The papa finishes his quarantine period. He just came back last night. And it's the same. I think we've come back to the same style of living that we were doing before we went to the hospital. So I've got another 10 more days left where I have to isolate, and only then I can meet my mother. So we haven't really met mom, we haven't really hugged her, we're just keeping our distance, like double isolation from the world, and then in our own households isolated from each other.
So you'll talk on the phone from room to room.
Yeah, now we only talk on the phone. Phone is everything.
So you'll have a large amount of staff who can, you know, manage the four of you, or I mean, how?
No. We don't have a large amount of staff, but we have
because in today's times,
many years, ever since I was a child, the same staff we've had, so they're with us. Yes, I'm very, very grateful for them. But they are also we take care of them also. They can't come into the room and
proper distance. And what are the don'ts the doctor has said, and the treatment, you know, the. I mean, क्या नहीं करना है, कौन सी दवाइयाँ लेनी है?
Yeah, I think दवाइयाँ wise, I think for each patient it's different. Like my dad was a heart patient, so I think medication, of course, for him is different. Medication for me is different. So I think depending on what your doctor thinks is right for you, is what is probably the right thing. But one thing that was general was they told us both that we must keep our immunity high, so we must make sure we're eating healthy food, fresh food, healthy. And eat on time, sleep on time, take your vitamins, which is the usual vitamin C, and you know, these kind of things
that raises immunity.
And they said breathing exercises, breathing exercises to keep the lungs strong and the oxygen level in the body maintained.
Are you allowed to eat non-veg food? Are you told not to
eat?
No,
I'm a vegetarian. I'm as it is a vegetarian.
All of you
was also vegetarian. Yeah, all of us. So because of us, even Papa. Papa very rarely eats meat because of his heart condition. Red meat is not good for him.
Yeah.
But he does have chicken once in a while. But he's also vegetarian as of now.
Okay, so he's avoiding it obviously.
Yeah, he's avoiding it.
Or, let's go over to a little about you. You know, we've been missing you. I mean, ever since we saw you launch in that movie, you know, before we round off this, I would like to know, kya ho raha hai? Are you going to do more movies, or you just, I mean, stopped midway somewhere, I think, and why? What happened?
I think after Always Kabhi Kabhi didn't do well, then, you know, it was a little hard to get the kind of work that I wanted to do, of course. Then I got Bhag Jauni, which I really, really loved script-wise and like project-wise, but that too didn't really do that well. So then after that, I thought maybe I should just lay off a bit and work on myself and see what it is that is going wrong. I think the failure of both the films didn't go down on me well. I think I was very young and I was not capable to handle my emotions in a very good way, I would say. So I think I needed to like back off a bit and get myself together. So I started theater. I joined a theater group. I did a couple of plays with Saleem Arif, so followed by, and then I got into web. Web, I got interesting offers because there were good roles, meaty roles. Yeah. I did two web shows for 35. One was Akuri, one was Bhutpurva. Another one for MX Player, Kali Crazy Dil. Like really nice roles, you know, something that I was looking out for. And then I did this tiny role in this film that Mr. Bhansali is supposed to be producing. It's the launch of Miss Poonam Dhillon's son. I did a small role in that, but I know the director, he's a friend. So that was coming back into the movie space, followed by, I'd finished shooting for Bijoy Nambiar. He's making this movie called Tesh. So we shot for that just recently, 6 months ago. So looking forward to that because Bijoy is a very, very good director. And then now I'm doing this web show for Amazon Prime called Fallen that Reema Kakdi is directing.
That's
so it's actually looking good now. Yeah.
So you're open to doing more web shows now? Like, I mean, that's the space you want to be in?
Totally. I just really want to work. I've not given up on my dream of my passion for my acting. I just thought that, you know, I need to lay off for a bit because something was going terribly wrong. So, and I feel like I put myself together and I'm back on track now. And I'm really feeling grateful about the things that are coming my way. So, let's see.
That's right. But didn't you try to, I mean, reach out to filmmakers? I know Webspace is a great space to be in now, today, or maybe since a year. But before that, you know, since your dad knows so many people, so didn't you all try to reach out to people? You know, I mean, people do reach out for work and say, okay, I want to do this film you're making, you know. I mean, whenever there are announcements and all. So,
I think I will do that. I just want to have a good enough work profile where I can go up to good directors and tell them that, you know, here, see, I did this. So, and they probably have something to show.
पहले नहीं किया आपने जब you just I mean
पहले किया था पर जब फिल्म चलती नहीं है तो फिर मुश्किल होता है right and then maybe that was just on my time I don't know but मैंने किया वो किया I met a lot of people I still keep meeting a lot of people I go for auditions doing it all like it's on but I think more what helps me more is what I'm doing with each day of mine I think that is what is actually getting me closer to my dream you know how I'm dealing with each day how I'm working on my craft how many acting workshops I'm doing. I think those are the things that are helping me more rather than just going out and being social and trying to meet people. Because if people will see my work and if I'm doing good in my work, then automatically I'm going to get it. So I'm just hoping on that.
How much are you a film buff? I mean, every Friday or every Saturday you all go for movies? Kitna?
Every Friday, every Saturday. Many times I'm first day, first show also. Full Bollywood buff I am. And I'm... watching movies has always been my favorite pastime hobby ever since I was a child.
Which have been your recent ones which have really you have you know been bowled over by
movies?
Yeah, 3 or 4 which you have you know really been impressed with.
I just right now during the quarantine period, I watched this show called The Stranger on Netflix. It was really really good. My mother asked me to watch it because she's read the author's books and she said that she's enjoyed his book. So I watched the show and it was really good. It was really gripping. And especially we were going through so much stress. So I really was trying to look for some show that really, you know,
motivates
me. Yeah. So So it was an interesting show, and then now I've been watching this thing, this show called Unorthodox.
Mm-hmm.
That's also very, very interesting. Yeah. I'm thinking of starting four more shorts please after this. After I'm done.
Any films which have impressed you in the recent past? That was my question, actually.
Yeah, I know, but I couldn't remember which films to say. That's why. I saw Maska recently. Very nice. I was looking for something lighthearted. I did watch good movies. I watched that movie about that boxer. About a boxer who loses, about his downfall and how he loses, he breaks his neck, but he still wants to come back.
So you're watching all these kind of movies, sort of a victory, rising like a phoenix.
No, I'm not intentionally doing that, but that was a really good movie. I can't believe I can't remember the name. It was really good. I'll tell you.
But but to round it off, Zuha, how is the day like now, when you get up till you retire for the night? What's the day? Schedule care.
I think ever since I've come back from the hospital, I've been at peace. I think pehle jab ye pura lockdown hua tha aur ye pura sab kuch start hua tha, I was so glued to the news and so glued. I was reading everything and I was just following all the news, and it was just so depressing and so heavy. And, my symptoms had also started. So it was just very, very heavy that whole period. But I think ever since I've come back from the hospital, I'm feeling thoda peaceful. I'm not reading too much of negative news anymore. I feel like I'm getting back to normal now. So I go to sleep early usually because I practice Ashtanga yoga. I haven't started yet because the doctor said to wait a bit, but I still go to sleep and I wake up at 6, and my yoga teacher has given me these breathing techniques that you have to do on an empty stomach in the morning.
Mm.
So I do all of that. I chant in the mornings. I find peace in doing that. So I do that. Followed by, I've been reading. I've been wanting to read these couple of acting books somebody recommended. So I was reading that. The autobiography of there's this one book it's right here. I love this book.
Okay.
And Al Pacino. I've been reading that, and something that helps me really a lot in my times when I'm going through a lot of negativity is this. It's a really cool book. It's like an interpretation of the Bhagavad Gita for the youth and how we can use it in our daily life. We can deal with our fears and everything. So yeah, I'm trying to get back to my reading, trying to use this time now to my benefit as much as possible.
And you sleep in time?
I sleep on time. I sleep 10 baje, I get up 6 o'clock like a child. Everyone makes fun of me, all my friends and family. Yeah. But this Ashtanga yoga practice and this whole discipline life has really helped me a lot. So I really bank on it. Even through this entire period, it helped give me my strength.
That has been a part of your, a part of you since the longest time. That's what you're saying, yeah.
Yeah, now it's 6 years. This is my 6th year into the practice.
That's fabulous. And well, I look forward to meeting you after this trauma is over. The COVID-19 is over. I really don't know when we will come out and, do you expect it will be over by May 4th?
I don't know. I was just talking to my sister and a couple of friends on the phone, and they all were like, they all think that it's going to get extended further. But I don't know. Depends.
Yeah.
Let's see. But of course, everyone's doing a great job. I think they're doing pretty well compared to other countries.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thankfully, you're not affected that badly. So.
Yeah. Seems that way. Yeah.
Yeah.
Chalo, let's wish that everything is all right, and it's once again on a very happy note that you three all, all the three of you are back home, and it's a big relief. It's a big moment of joy, if I would say, because all three together, it's easier said than done. I can understand what the family went through, and thank you so much for being a part of this conversation, for this whole interview. A big thank you from Spot Boy.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Thank you, Zoha.
Bye.